Hey guys, welcome back in lecture 2 of TypeScript 5 for Absolute Beginners course. In this lecture, we will cover an overview of TypeScript's fundamentals. And in fundamentals, we will cover the topics, variables and data types, type annotations and inference, difference in constants, let and var, basic operators and control structures. First, let's see what are the variables in programming. A variable is like a container or box in a program that stores data. It is identified by a name. The value in a variable can be updated as the program runs. In TypeScript, we have these basic data types: number, string, boolean, null, undefined, any. Numbers in TypeScript work the same way as they do in JavaScript. Number type variables are declared with the data type number. Textual variable will be declared with the string data type. TypeScript also uses double quotes or single quotes to store string data. Variables which show the predicate in which we return true or false, for that we will use boolean data type. Then we have null and undefined data types. Null is the intentional absence of a value, and null must be assigned to a variable. Undefined is the unintentional absence of a value, and the default value of any unassigned variable is undefined. Any data type we used when a variable's type is unknown or when the variable's type hasn't yet been defined. How we declare variable in TypeScript. Variables in TypeScript can be declared using the let, const, and var keywords. Let's see the syntax to declare a variable in TypeScript. We can declare a variable by let, var, or const. Here I'm using let. Next, I need to define the variable name. After colon, I'm going to give its data type, number. And after this, I'm going to give value to it. Left side of equal is called declaration of variable, and right side is called assignment of variable. Actually, we have two types to declare a variable: type annotations and inference. Type annotations are used to explicitly specify the data type of a variable, and type inference are used to automatically infer or deduce the data type of a variable. Now in this example, I have declared the variable using type annotation because I'm explicitly defining the type of the variable. Same if I want to define it using type infer, then h2 equal number. Now this both the variables have type number, but in first we will declare it using type annotation and in second we declare it using type inference. Then we have data type string. Next, there is boolean data type. Then there is data type any, and in any we can store any kind of data. Then we need to explore the difference between const, let and var. Constants are immutable variables defined with const. Let is used for block scoped variables and var for function scoped variables. Let's explore these three by using an example. We have already declared variables with let. Now I'm going to declare a variable with const. Constant, first of month, and its data type is number, is equal to 1. Now if I want to change it, then it must give an error. As you can see, we can't change the value of const variables. Now let's see the difference between let and var. We have a code block. In this if block, if I define my variable with let, then this h3 variable only accessible in this block. But if I change this variable to var, then we can also access it out of the block. Next, we will see basic operators and control structures. This part of lecture contains basic operators, conditional statements, loops, and exception handling. What are the basic operators in TypeScript? TypeScript supports arithmetic, comparison, logical, and assignment operators. Let's see these all in a coding example. First, let's see the example of arithmetic operators. I'm going to create two number type variables and then perform arithmetic operations on them. Let's see its result after the execution. This is the way we can perform arithmetic operations in TypeScript 5. Next, we will see the example of comparison operators, and these 6 are comparison operators in TypeScript. Next, we have logical operators. In logical operators, we have AND and OR gate. Let's implement them. So, we can use comparison operators and logical operators together. Then we have assignment operator. By this, we can assign one variable value to another variable. Like here, I'm assigning number 1 variable's value to number 2 variable. Let's build and run the application so that we can see the result of all the operators. As you can see, these comparison and logical operators returns boolean value. Next, we have conditional statements. In TypeScript, we have 2 types of conditional statements. One is if-else and second is switch. If-else used to execute a block of code if a condition is true or false, which used to select one of many code blocks to be executed. Now let's see the example of both the conditional statements. Let a variable color, and then I'm going to use this color variable in our if and else block. So this is the way we can implement if-else block in TypeScript, exactly like we implement in other languages. Then there is a switch block. We can also use this color variable in our switch block, but in switch we will implement cases. On the basis of particular value, we will implement one case. As you can see, we implemented same condition in both blocks. But what is the difference between if-else and switch block? In if-else, we can implement more conditions, but in switch, I can implement only one condition based on that color variable. So for simple scenarios, we definitely use switch statement, and for complex scenarios, we can use if-else statement so that we can use more complex conditions. Now let's build and run the application to see the output. And in both the cases, we get the output color is red. Next, we have loops in TypeScript. In this lecture, we will see the most basic loops in TypeScript: for, while, and do while. For used to execute a block of code a specified number of times, and while used to execute a block of code while a condition is true. Do while similar to the while loop, but the code block is executed at least once before the condition is checked. Let's see their coding example. In this for loop, I'm going to print table of 2. Let's execute it. Same output we can print by using while loop. Now what is the difference between both for loop and while loop? In for loop we define our start and end with the condition, but in while loop we only specifying our condition, and then after writing a console.log we are just incrementing our I variable for the sake of iteration. Let's execute again to see the output. Now this while loop will run right after see the condition. If the condition is true, then it will execute. But if I want a single force loop at the start, then I will use do while loop. Now as you can see, this condition will never execute because 11 less than and equal to 10 condition will be false. But because of do while, it will print our statement first time and then it will stop the execution. Let's execute again. add, it's printed only one statement. After the condition is false, it just stops the execution. Then we have exception handling in TypeScript. In exception handling, we have three blocks, try, catch, and finding. Try block is used to enclose a block of code that may throw an exception, and catch used to handle the exception thrown by the try block. Finding used to specify a block of code that will be executed regardless of whether an exception was thrown or not. Let's see its coding example. Let number 1 type number equal 10. Let divider of type number equal 2. In try, I'm going to divide these two numbers. Right now, for the sake of simplicity, I'm only going to write console.log in our catch block. Then our last block is finally block, which must be executed in every condition. Let's execute it. And of course, we don't have any exception right now, so it must print only try and finally block. As you can see, it printed try and finally block. So this lecture was on basic overview of TypeScript fundamentals. Hope you understand it, and we will see these all things in more detail, and we will move forward from basic to advanced. So guys, stay connected. If this video is helpful for you, then please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.